Jeopardy! Now entering the studio are today's contestants. A plastic surgeon from Newport Beach, California, Dr. Ira Levine. A graduate student from Fayetteville, Arkansas, Stephen Bradshaw. And our returning champion, an attorney from South Salem, New York, Bob McGreevy, who on our last show won $11,150. And now, here is the host of Jeopardy, Alex Trebek.
Thank you, Johnny. Thank you, folks. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome once again to Jeopardy. If you were watching our last program, you saw our current champion, Bob the Marathoner, run away with the win and pick up a lot of cash. And today, he defends against Stephen and Ira. I know you're eager to get into this match, so let's get to it. Good luck to all three of you. The board will go in motion. I'll remind you that we'll have just the one daily double in this round. If you're lucky enough to uncover it, it could help you a lot. In one of these categories, USA, mammals, tennis, TV nostalgia, cowboy talk, and finally an old Jeopardy standby, potpourri. Bob, you select first as returning champ.
Let's try mammals for 100, Alex.
First clue of the match. Unlike large leopards, leopard cats have some of these arranged in rows. Bob?
What are spots?
That's right.
Mammals for 200.
Nearly 25% of all mammal species are varieties of these, the only mammals that can fly. Stephen?
What are bats?
That's it.
Mammals for 300.
Since they never stop growing, the oldest of these pachyderms are usually the largest. Ira.
What are elephants?
Right, you're in the lead.
USA for 100, please.
Montana's tallest building, an 18-story bank, is in this city that sounds like buildings. Ira.
What is Billings, Montana?
Billings, Montana is right.
USA for 200, please.
It's rumored the buyer thought he bought a different bridge when he bought this one now at Lake Havasu, Arizona. Ira.
What is the London Bridge?
That's correct.
USA for 300, please.
At the water bar in this affluent city surrounded by L.A., you can order 55 varieties of H2O. Stephen?
What is Hollywood?
No, sorry. Ira?
What is Beverly Hills?
That is the correct response.
USA for 400, please.
Juarez, the largest Mexican border city, lies across from this largest Texas border city. Ira?
What is El Paso?
Good for $400 more.
USA for 500, please.
This city of lakes, with 22 lakes inside city limits, is the largest in the land of 10,000 lakes. Ira?
What is Minneapolis and
That's right, and that wraps up the category. You've got $1,800 and control of the board.
How about potpourri for 100, please?
Potpourri for 1. The answer is, it's said many 17th century women had no eyelashes because they singed them off when blowing out these. Bob?
What are candles?
Correct.
Mammals for $400.
Back to that one. Eland, bongos, and impalas are three types of this animal. Stephen?
What are gazelles?
No, sorry. Bob?
What are antelope?
Antelope is right.
Mammals for $500.
Their name is Greek for river horse, and aptly, they give birth to their young in the water. Bob?
What are hippopotamuses?
Yes.
Tennis for 100.
Tennis for 1. Of the baseline or service line, the one that's farther back. Ira?
What is the baseline?
Right.
Tennis for 300, please.
The answer? A high school dropout, this great Swedish star dropped out of the pro tour at only 26. Stephen?
Who is Bjorn Borg?
That's right.
Tennis for 200.
One word term used when the score is 40-40. Ira?
What is deuce?
That is right, and that takes us to our first commercial break, and you're doing well, Ira. You're the only one over the $2,000 mark. Stephen, still on the negative side, but that's starting to turn around for him. We'll find out if it continues when we continue the first round on Jeopardy following these commercial messages.
Back in 78, Mazda taught the sports car world a lesson about what you get for what you pay. Well, they're still doing it. This new RX-7 SE comes with a bunch of good stuff, like aluminum wheels. There's power steering, even a stereo. All standard. Not only that, this new RX-7 beats the Porsche 944 to 60, and also beats it by close to 12 grand. I guess old Mazda's still giving him a lesson or two.
We're tossing them fresh, tossing them crisp. McDonald's chicken salad oriental.
New chef salad. New McDonald's garden salad. Three new tastes, you know you gotta have it. We're tossing them fresh, tossing three great salads. And all you gotta say is,
toss me a salad.
It's a good time for the great taste. Three new tastes, tossed fresh all day.
Within the next 24 hours, this could be yours. A Rent-A-Center home entertainment system. TV, VCR, stereo, dual cassette deck, remote control. Only $19.95 a week, rent to own. And if you're not happy, you get back your first week's rent. Now that's a great deal. Once again, this could be yours. Only $19.95 a week. They're going fast. Call now. Rent-A-Center. Count on us for a great deal.
I've got an idea.
Why doesn't New Coke have a taste test where New Coke takes on Pepsi, and we'll call it the New Coke Pop Quiz?
They have? Where?
When Coke did take on Pepsi in nationwide tests, more people chose Coke over Pepsi. Prove it to yourself. You'll see why more people are choosing the taste of Coke. Catch the wave. Coke.
I've got another idea, but I'm not telling you.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Before we spend some time talking with our contestants, I have to be the bearer of bad tidings, unfortunately, to one of them, the first player we introduced, the doctor from Newport Beach, Dr. Ira Levine. That response you gave a little while ago in the USA category of Minneapolis, you added St. Paul at the end with regard to the 22 lakes within city limits, and that applies only to Minneapolis. So we have to deduct the $1,000, $500 and $500 for an incorrect. So you're tied for the lead right now. But let's find out about you. You're involved as a fundraiser for a playhouse in Laguna Beach. Which one?
It's the Laguna Moulton Playhouse, which I believe is the oldest continuously operating community theater west of something.
I see. So you're a fundraiser and a contributor. Are you also an actor or a person involved in the production?
I'm trying to kind of sneak in through the back door that way.
Okay. Well, nice having you with us on the program. The man next to you is Stephen Bradshaw. We discovered in Memphis. You're at minus 200 right now, Stephen. Don't let that worry you. You're a graduate student in philosophy.
Yes.
We had a lady who was working towards her degree in philosophy earlier this week. She wants to teach it. What are you going to do?
I would like to teach it if I could, but I'm taking some courses in computer science. I'll probably get a degree in that as well, knowing the realities of the world.
Okay. I like your attitude. All right. The champion is Robert McGreevy from South Salem, New York, an attorney who lives in the woods with, and I love this, with how many cats and dogs?
11 cats and originally 3 dogs, one of which belonged to a neighbor, but who lived with us for about 5 years, and he just died before I came out here to the show, but he was about 18, so he had a good life.
He had a good life, and he had the company of all those other cats and dogs.
And his name was Champ.
Champ?
Champ.
Okay, well, you are the champ, but unfortunately you're not in control of the board right now because Ira gave us the last correct response, so he will select again. Go ahead, Ira.
Okay, how about Potpourri 200?
The answer is, Marigold was an appropriate name for this legendary king's daughter. Ira?
Who is King Midas?
That's right.
Potpourri 300.
Follower of Jesus, who was born in the village of Magdala. Bob?
Who's Mary Magdalene?
That is right.
Tennis for 400.
Tennis for 4. Native country of all 4 finalists in men's and women's singles at the 1986 U.S. Open. Stephen.
What is Czechoslovakia?
You're right, and you're on the plus side.
Tennis for 500.
This national championship is generally considered the world's foremost clay court event. Stephen.
What is the French Open?
That's good for $500.
Potpourri for 400.
John Philip Sousa added a removable bell to a helicon, creating this instrument. Stephen?
What is the sousaphone?
That's good for 400 more.
Potpourri for 500.
Last clue in the column. To prevent corrosion, most hot water pipes are now made of this. Bob?
What is copper?
Copper is right. Where to?
Cowboy talk for 100.
A necktie party was one of these, not a Father's Day celebration. Bob?
What is a hanging?
That's right.
Cowboy talk for $200.
This 4-letter word can refer to a chunk of tobacco or a broken down horse. Ira.
What is a mare?
No, sorry. Bob.
What is a chaw?
No. What is a plug?
Plug,
the genuine Mexican plug that Mark Twain wrote about. Bob, you select, please.
Cowboy talk for 300.
Alliterative term for Jim Bridger, Kit Carson, Jeremiah Johnson, and other trappers who roamed the Rockies. Stephen.
Well, we're mountain men.
That's it.
Cowboy talk for 400.
A cowboy's wang strings are used to tie equipment to this, his rig. Stephen.
What is a saddle?
That's it.
Cowboy talk for 500.
To Pecos a varmint meant killing him this way. Bob.
What is shoot him in the back?
No, sorry. Stephen or Ira? It meant to drown him. A reference, of course, to the Pecos River. Stephen, you select again, please.
I guess TV nostalgia for 100.
This series inspired the Brady Kids and the Brady Brides. Stephen?
What was the Brady Bunch?
Right, we've got less than a minute to go.
TV nostalgia for 200.
Comedy series on which Flo, when peeved, would tell Mel to kiss my grits. Ira?
What is Alice?
That's it.
TV nostalgia 300, please.
Of Manimal, Logan's Run, or Joni Loves Chachi, the one that lasted into its second season. Bob.
What is Joni Loves Chachi?
That's it.
TV nostalgia for 400.
The answer? Mino Palouse and John Eric Hexum were time travelers Jeffrey and Phineas on this 1982 series. Stephen.
What was Explorers?
No, sorry. Ira or Bob? You were close, Stephen. You had the right idea. What was Voyagers? Bob, you get to select.
TV nostalgia for $500.
Last clue is, since we haven't discovered it yet, the Daily Double. And it's an audio. You've got a $100 lead over Stephen right now, Bob. The category is television nostalgia. How much do you want to risk?
Oh, I tell you, I think I'll just bet $100, Alex.
For $100, here comes the music and the clue. In series with the following theme, the first scene usually featured a tape recorder and this character. Bob, have you got a response for me?
What is, who's Peter Graves?
No, sorry, you're giving me the name of the actor who portrayed Jim Phelps. Remember the line, all right, Mr. Phelps, this tape will self-destruct. And our board has self-destructed because there are no clues left on it. You had that momentary recognition. You knew the television series immediately.
Everything but his name.
Everything but his name. Okay, that wraps up this first round of play. We've got a tie for the lead, Bob and Stephen at 1,500, and we're going to take a break. We'll be back with Double Jeopardy right after this.
Early one afternoon.
Where's Lou?
At the Silver Bullet.
Lou, Jackie, Jackie, comedian. You ever think of having live entertainment? Because this place is dead. Of course you did. I'm hysterical. Look at these reviews. Some of these places are still open. I'll pack them in, Lou.
No. Coors Light does that.
I don't know who this guy Light is.
No, Coors Light isn't a guy. It's a beer.
A bear. Terrific animal acts. I can't get a break in this town.
Did you hear the one about the mouse?
Come on. There's no slowing down with the Silver Bullet tonight.
Hello. Oh, hi, honey. Dinner. Well, we can have a spinach salad.
With Good Seasons, you can make most anything on your mind.
Red wine vinegar with olive oil and Good Seasons Italian. Oh, wait a second.
Oh, no.
How about a chef's salad? I'll add mayo and sour cream. Oh, hold on. A vegetable salad with Dijon mustard dressing. Okay, see you later.
Good Seasons salad dressing mix. From one packet, the ideas keep pouring out.
It's spring rally time at your local Ford dealer. That means the best deals yet on Ford Taurus, Tempo, and Escort. Take the hot-selling touring sedan Ford Taurus. Base price just $10,650. Now get low financing or cash back direct from Ford. We're dealing now on every new Ford in stock during the Ford Spring Rally. And we back every new Ford we sell with a 6-year, 60,000-mile powertrain warranty. That's value. That's the Ford Spring Rally. See your local Ford dealer today before they're all gone.
Isn't it cruel and pink? Isn't it cruel to think what the others miss when it comes to this? Cherry 7 up, can't get enough. Who can you cherry best?
Very cool. close match underway. I hope it continues throughout the Double Jeopardy round. Two daily doubles in this one. First, the dollar figures, please. Now the categories. Starting off with business and industry. Right next to that, we've got classical music, presidential quotes, Black America, bodies of water, and finally, English literature. Ira, you're in third place, but not by much. You get to select first in this round.
Great, thanks a lot. How about classical music 200, please?
The answer is, in 1869, Tchaikovsky wrote a tone poem about these Shakespearean teenagers. Ira?
Who are Romeo and Juliet?
Yes, we have a three-way tie right now. Go.
Classical music 400, please.
The answer there is a daily double. You see the score. You've all got the same amount of money, but you have the daily double. How much do you want to risk?
About $1,000.
For $1,000 in classical music, here is the clue. When Mendelssohn was a teen, this couple hired an orchestra so he could try out his music.
I have no idea.
The correct response is, who were his parents?
His parents.
Okay, you drop down to 500, but you retain control of the board. Go again.
Okay, classic music 600.
Though he may not have liked the term, he wrote impressionistic works such as Clair de Lune. Bob.
Who's Debussy?
Claude Debussy, right.
Classical music for 800.
Though used in orchestral music, the allemande, sarabande, and gigue are actually types of these. Ira.
What are dances?
That's right.
Bodies of water, 200, please.
Starting it off with, Magellan discovered this stormy passage that connects the Pacific and Atlantic Oceans. Bob.
What are the Straits of Magellan?
Correct.
Bodies of water for 400.
Of lakes Titicaca, Tahoe, or Tanganyika, the highest navigable lake in the world. Stephen.
What is Titicaca?
That's right.
Bodies of water for 600.
This river began carving out the Grand Canyon perhaps as long as 12 million years ago. Bob.
What is the Colorado River?
That is right.
Bodies of water for 800.
The answer there is the second daily double. We're getting both of them out of the way rather quickly in this round. Bob, you've got $1,000 more than Stephen, who is in second place. How much do you want to risk?
I'll bet $1,000, Alex.
Okay. In bodies of water, here is the clue. The number of oceans that wash up on U.S. shorelines.
What are two?
Sorry, that is incorrect. You remember the Atlantic and Pacific. Obviously, you forgot the Arctic Ocean, which washes up on
Alaska.
All right, select again.
Bodies of water for 1,000.
Bordering India, Bangladesh, and Burma, it's the biggest bay in the world. Ira?
What is the Bay of Bengal?
Good, for 1,000.
Presidential quotes, 200, please.
He bragged, I'm as strong as a bull moose, and you can use me to the limit. Bob?
Who's Teddy Roosevelt?
That's right.
Classical music for 1,000.
The answer? Though he began studying with Salieri, this composer still left one symphony unfinished. Ira?
Who is Brahms?
No, sorry. Stephen?
Who is Schubert?
Schubert, the famous unfinished symphony. You are right, and you're in the lead with 2,900. Go.
Presidential quotes for 400.
In his 1981 farewell, he said, America did not invent human rights. Human rights invented America. Stephen?
Who is Jimmy Carter?
Right.
Presidential quotes for 600.
I was inaugurated at Montgomery, February 18th, 1861, with A.H. Stevens of Georgia as vice president. Stephen?
Who is Jeff Davis?
That's right.
Presidential quotes for 800.
This general reportedly said, Venice would be a fine city if it were drained. Ira.
Who is Eisenhower?
No, sorry.
Who is Ulysses Grant? Stephen, we'll go back to you.
The next selection.
Let's finish it up. 1,000.
The answer? He said, if you don't say anything, you won't be called on to repeat it. Ira.
Who is Calvin Coolidge?
That's good for 1,000.
English literature, 600, please.
Middle of that column. Bronte's sister, who caught cold at her brother's funeral and died a few months later. Ira.
Who is Emily Bronte?
Emily, yeah, you were going on a guess and it paid off. Nice going.
English literature, 800, please.
The answer? 19th century poet whose husband often called her my little Portuguese. Bob.
Who's Browning?
Be more specific.
Robert Browning and who is
Sorry, Ira?
Who is Elizabeth Barrett Browning?
Elizabeth Barrett Browning, right.
English literature, 1,000, please.
The answer is, he gave up writing novels after the public's shocked reaction to Jude the Obscure. Bob.
Who's Thomas Hardy?
That's good for $1,000.
Black America for 200.
Starting it off with, this Chicago-based talk show host once won the Miss Black Tennessee pageant. Stephen.
Who is Oprah Winfrey?
That's it.
Black America for 400.
While she stars on Fame, her sister Felicia stars on The Cosby Show. The lady's name is Debbie Allen. We've got a minute to go, Stephen. Select.
600, Black America, please.
As assistant to this explorer, Matthew Henson became the first Black American to reach the North Pole. Stephen.
Who is Perry?
Robert Perry's right.
Black America for 800.
The answer? In 1967, he became the first Black U.S. Supreme Court Justice. Stephen again.
Who is Thurgood Marshall?
That's right.
Black America for 1,000.
Dr. Joseph Lowry now heads this million-member group founded by the Reverend Martin Luther King, Jr. Bob.
Who's the Southern Christian Leadership Conference?
You got it, yes. All right, select again.
English Literature for $200.
The answer at the top. Some regard this great Dickens novel as not only a pip, but the finest English novel ever written. Bob?
What's Great Expectations?
Correct, select.
English Literature for $400.
Sybil is one of the many novels written by this man, Queen Victoria's Prime Minister. Bob.
Who's Disraeli?
That's right. Go. We won't get a chance to get any answers revealed in the business and industry category. We've got Stephen in the lead with $5,500. The other gentleman still in the thick of this. Remember, at the end of Final Jeopardy, the player with the most cash will be the champ. The others will get these prizes.
For today's second place contestant, we'll fly you and a companion from Los Angeles to New York aboard Delta Airlines with standard and wide body service. You may visit Delta's exclusive Crown Room Lounge before boarding, and while in flight, experience their warm and friendly hospitality furnished by Delta Airlines. And you'll enjoy a week's stay at the Roseland Ranch in Stanfordville, New York. Casual ranch resort activities. You may swim in the indoor pool, explore the ranch on horseback, snowmobile, or ski. From Roseland Ranch. Today's third place contestant will receive a Speed Queen washer like those used in coin-op laundries, with stainless steel tub for gentle care of all your fabrics, with matching dryer for today's washing needs from Speed Queen. And now let's go back to Alex Trebek.
I got a letter from one of our contestants who went to Roseland Ranch, had a wonderful time. I've never gotten a letter from anyone who's gotten a washer dryer, though. Maybe it'll come. Final Jeopardy category today is this. 1968. Our gentleman will think about that. We'll be back with a clue following this break.
Say when, Ernie.
Keep putting more big, soft, chocolatey chips into our Chips Deluxe cookies.
Right. Just say when. Soon as we put in enough chips, you holler, okay? We'll add big, soft chips till you say when, Ernie. Ernie?
Keebler Chips Deluxe cookies have more big, soft, chocolatey chips than ever before.
Ernie! Wow!
When? Keebler Chips Deluxe Cookies. More big, soft, chocolatey chips than ever before.
Admit it. Your house needs help. Find help at the Kmart Glidden Vacation Paint Sale Sweepstakes. No need to be afraid of painting with bargains like Glidden Spread Satin for $8.57 and Glidden Spread House Paint for only $10.87. Plus, you can win a Boston Whaler Temptation 2500 with Twin Yamaha outboards or a Boston Whaler Supersport and more. Paint now, party later with Glidden Paint on sale at Kmart, America's favorite store.
The competition heats up as we head into the final Jeopardy round next.
The Dodge Truck Blitz is on, and your nearby Dodge dealer is kicking it off with the new Easterner, a tough new full-size pickup just for this area, with features like a new 770 protection plan, automatic transmission, two-tone paint, and a list price $1,538 less than a comparably equipped Ford F-150, $1,028 less than a comparably equipped Chevy R10. Plus, for a limited time, get 3-7 financing or $500 back. See the new Easterner during the Dodge Truck Blitz right now at your Dodge dealer.
My kitty cat craves loving. My kitty cat craves fun. Now when he craves the great taste of Crave, he has three choices, not one.
Crave cat food seafood recipe with tuna, shrimp, and salmon proteins. Crave poultry recipe with chicken, turkey, and giblets proteins. An original recipe Crave. All made with real protein-rich foods, not just flavors. So your cat can have his Crave and variety too.
A Crave for every craving. Get all the love he's saving. Cause your kitty cat craves Crave.
Good morning, class. Cookology. The study of
good taste.
In fact, the taste that stands the test.
Yes!
The test where new Coke takes on Pepsi, i.e.
That's as in?
The new Coke pop quiz. Cookologist! All others pay attention.
When Coke did take on Pepsi in nationwide tests, more people chose Coke over Pepsi. Prove it to yourself. You'll see why more people are choosing the taste of Coke. Catch the wave. Coke.
As Frank Sinatra would say, it was a very good year, 1968. That's our category for Final Jeopardy. The wagers have been made. When I give you the answer, you'll have 30 seconds in which to write down the question. Be sure your response is phrased in the form of a question, please. Here we go. Today's Final Jeopardy clue is this. On Christmas Eve and Christmas Day of 1968, Frank Borman, William Anders, and James Lovell Jr. did this 10 times. Good luck, players. We're going to start down there with Dr. Ira Levine. $2,900, third place going into Final Jeopardy. Did he come up with the right Final Jeopardy response? What is to walk on the moon? Sorry, that is wrong. How much did you wager? $2,900. That knocks you down to zero. We move down to this end to our returning champion, Bob McGreevy. Picked up over $11,000 yesterday. Did he get the right question today?
Not today.
What is walked on the moon? You too were wrong. How much did you wager? $38.99, leaving you with $1. We move now to Stephen Bradshaw, who was leading with $5,500. What did Stephen put down? What is circle the moon? That is the correct response. So we've got a new Jeopardy champion with how much money for Stephen? $2,400, taking him to $7,900. So Stephen Bradshaw, congratulations. And Bob and Ira, thank you both for a great match as well.
One memorable night.
Thanks, Rob.
At the Silver Bullet.
Hey, you're Don Adams, right?
Yes. One Coors Light, please.
Would you believe? Two Coors Lights.
Great.
Ring, ring. Hello? It's for you, Don.
Terrific.
Oh, thanks. Mind if I join you?
Mind if I pour?
Not at all. Missed it by that much.
There's no slowing
That's
down
great.
With the Silver Bullet tonight.
I just did.
Fuss with shampoo and conditioner? Who needs it? I want to wash my hair and go. And now I can. With new Pert Plus. Complete shampoo plus complete conditioner in one bottle. Pert Plus leaves my hair clean, conditioned, and looking terrific. Before, to get results this good, I used shampoo and conditioner. No more. Now, with Pert Plus, I just wash and go.
New Pert Plus. Shampoo plus complete conditioner in one.
A gigantic tent sale at Bill Zekakis Chevrolet and Imports.
And check out our center ring special.
Save on Chevrolets, Volvos, Mazdas, Subarus, BMWs, Isuzus, and used vehicles. All factory incentives apply during this sale.
Hurry, hurry, hurry. The savings end soon.
At Zekakis Chevrolet and Imports, Route 13 South in Ithaca.